down, and you kind of work together. We're going to be working a little bit together here, and one of the things you guys are in sports management, and one of the things in sports management that I think is powerful is that you guys could change the world. One of the things that we do when we organize sports, because that's what we're going to do later, is you help set a great badminton club, or, there we go, come on in. Excuse me. Can you give me 10 push-ups?
1, 2, 3.
They talk about Singapore because of the Youth Olympic Games, because of the Formula One, because of the race around the world in sailing. They talk about Singapore around the world because of sport. Singapore is known around the world as being a great country and the quality of the sports programs. And that's what you're going to do. You're going to help the country be great. See, that's what great countries do. We're there to make somebody else better. But when Michael Phelps races, there's a lot of people around him that helps him. And the most important people are the coach and all his teammates. Because when you have a bad day in training and your teammate goes, "Michael, come on, let's finish this workout together. Let's have a great workout." It makes a great workout. It takes people with very strong values to run a great sport organization, because people will push you along all the time. Think about this. Little kids that can't swim a lap of the pool, and now they swim a lap of the pool because you're a swim teacher. What happened to that kid? Does he touch the wall and go, "Oh." He touches the wall and go, "Yay, I did it." Or when you run the first 5K ever, or you speak in front of the class for the first time. We build confidence in kids. Sports management, we're not talking about anything else here. Sports management. We use sport to change the world. Rugby, baseball, soccer. Some people use music. We use sport.